Mailman here from Goat Productions. Throwback to the old 22 mag days. This is what I started with. The original rifle I started with when I started the hog hunt. I got a piece of property where there's a lot of neighbors on the upslope of the hill. Once I get over top of this ridge, I'm able to use them high caliber rifles and I can shoot over there. The sound doesn't bother the neighbors. In the front though, I want to try and keep it a little bit quieter. I do not have a silencer, so I jump back to the 22 mag. I'm also going to jump from kill number, I believe 35 on my YouTube, up to 40, I believe 47. I'm not sure. I'll put it on the front cover. But why I did that is I bought a 6.5 Grendel from Bear Creek Arsenal. I had to throw a scope on it, so I took my old Thor LT that does not record. It's a thermal from ATN that does not record, and I've been running into hogs. I got three really good groups of hogs. I went to two spots tonight. The first spot, I took eight out of a wheat field the other night. I knew they'd be back. I ran into a hog early, 9 o'clock. It was daylight. I drove by and I seen the hog out in the field. I tried to move in on this hog with the LT on my 6.5 Grendel. I actually pushed a hog into the woods. I probably could have taken a shot, but I did. I wanted to wait for a better shot. I waited there about an hour and a half. That was my first spot. That hog did not come back out. I thought he would. I'll get him because I know where he's coming out and he's hitting that weed hard. Hit a second property, saw nothing. I got to my third property about 12 midnight. This is the property where Hunter took the 387 pounder the other night. There's about 20 plus hogs in this group. But like I said, there's a certain area. When me and Hunter were there, we had to wait an hour and a half for the hogs to move to an area that we could shoot. Well, I didn't want to spend that amount of time there, so that's why I put the X-Sight 4K 3-14 on my 22 mag. I'm able to shoot in that front field. I'm still far enough away from the houses, but I'm not going to wake up those neighbors. Pull in, I open up the gate, and I actually scan when I open up the gate. The last time they were in the oaks to our left, right there alongside the road. Today they were to the right out in the field. Probably, I would say, a group of 16. But as I stalked in, there was one hog that stayed there probably about 100 yards from the other hogs, but he really digging and concentrating. What they'll do sometimes, man, is they put their head down and they start to dig, and you can really stalk up close. 22 mag, perfect scenario, 32 yards. How I know, I had my binocs. I took those with me. I put those on another tripod, and I carried the 22 Magnum on my shoulder, and I'd move in closer, Got into an area where I could see into the weeds with the night vision. You're going to have a little bit of high weeds in the area, but I put that binocs on a tripod, focused it on that hog, got onto my 22 mag here with the 3x14. Now, I'm glad I brought the binocs because I did not have an SD card inside of my 3x14. The binocs, the video you're going to see is going to be the binocs video. Now, I really like this setup here. Nice and quiet. What I did is I put the Swagger bipod on here so that I can carry it on my shoulder, extend the legs out, sit however I want, and I got my Coyote Reaper XXL IR from Predator Tactics, and it fits right between that bipod. Awesome. I mean, I love the way that thing sits in there. So what I did is I stalked up really close. Like I said, got within 32 yards. I love those close-up stalks sometimes. Reminds me of the old days when I used to do it when I first started. So going to show you a little bit of footage here. I'm on hogs major now. I got three really good groups. Group of 19, another group of probably 20 on a piece of property, and I'm weeding out those ones in the wheat. That one's probably going to be a later property now because I pushed them off the early. We're going to get back on it later. So check out this footage from the binocs. More to come. Get to that 50 by the end of June. We're halfway through the year, halfway to our 100, and we're going to get the rest of them here for you. So stay tuned. We're going to have many more. Thanks for liking, subscribing, and here's the good stuff.